Welcome to AGTV. I'm so thankful to all of you that have been standing by me, praying for me and believing God for my quick recovery. In today's episode, we're going to feature three major segments, and I'm introducing for the first time this segment titled The Gospel Truth. And then we're going to have a clip of the music of Pastor Julian Awari featuring his album release concert. And then we're going to wrap up with an interview with a business leader from Nigeria, Mr. Abraham Umoh, hosted by my co-host, Shanta Charles. So now, welcome once again, and enjoy this little segment that I titled The Gospel Truth. And this is part one. For the good news of the kingdom of God to mankind to have the desired effect of ever increasing number of souls being won into the kingdom, it must remain simple and preach with the same passion Jesus did. Mark chapter number 1 verses 14 to 15 amplified version says, "Now after John was arrested and put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the good news, the gospel of the kingdom of God," verse 15, "and saying, the appointed period of time is fulfilled, completed, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent, have a change of mind which issues in regretful past sins and change of conduct for the better." Jesus Christ preached a very simple gospel, but the human mind finds it, you know, difficult to believe and accept. It is not complicated, you know, to some, because it doesn't require works and human efforts. Others resort to human reasoning and have distorted the truth, you know, in order to please their listeners and, you know, kind of make them feel good. The Bible states in Romans chapter 5, verse 8-9, amplified version, "But God shows and clearly proves His own love for us by the fact that while we were still sinners, Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One, died for us. Therefore, since we are now justified, otherwise acquitted, made righteous, and brought into right standing or right relationship with God by Christ's blood, how much more certain is it that we shall be saved by Him from indignation and wrath of God?" You see, Jesus Christ paid the price to authenticate the gospel, the good news of salvation, to all who dare to believe in Him. Any other gospel preach that is not Christ-centered is merely, you know, catering to man's, you know, happiness, and it's not the true gospel. The kingdom of God is actually the rulership of Christ in the heart of the believer, where, you know, you can enjoy His righteousness, His peace, His joy with the help of the Holy Spirit. But you must first, you know, repent from your sins. Believe in your heart, confess from your mouth that Jesus is the Lord. He is the Lord over your life. I mean, absolute surrender of your heart to the influence of the Holy Spirit. That's the gospel truth.
Are y'all doing that? Awesome. I just want to say thank you guys for coming out tonight. Some of you may remember where several years ago I actually did a concert, and it was about an identity album, which was never officially released. In the process, the Lord has been changing it and molding it and shifting it, and you know, now we have something new and fresh for you guys. But after that last concert, I've experienced a lot of changes. I became youth pastor here at this church. I got married. I had two babies. And so I've been learning even more. I've been learning even more in the process. And, you know, God's timing is everything. And this is God's time. I mean, just so... this is so surreal for me right now, so thank you guys so much. God bless you. Have fun tonight.
This is my life, my testimony, my everyday struggle, and I thank God for his anointing. Can I give it to y'all? Here we go.
Oh, Today we have with us Abraham Umoh, who is a Christian business leader from Nigeria. Abraham, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Shante.
Glad you could join us. Tell us a little bit about your background.
Like you've said already, I'm a Christian and a businessman and a business leader in Nigeria. I came into the U.S. for the Joseph Business School Conference, which held in Chicago, basically to help businesses take Christ to the marketplace. But back in Nigeria, I work for a management development company, Mark P. Nigeria Limited, into management development and entrepreneurship development. I'm also a member of the National Executive Committee of the Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International. They have oversight responsibility for 160 chapters in what we call a district. And that's about 2,000 plus membership. I'm also part of the faculty, actually I head the faculty of the Joseph Business School in Uyo in Akwa Ibom State. And also as part of my ministry, I have a call to teach pastors administration and leadership. So basically that's my background. I been to some good schools. I was in Université de Nice in France. I went to University of Nigeria in Suka, and I have a graduate degree in business from University of Science and Technology, Port Harcourt, all in Nigeria.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about how you came to know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior.
Well, that's many years ago, as far back as 1982. When I came back from France in 1979, I met a young lady. I was interested in her, but she didn't seem to like my lifestyle. I didn't understand what it meant, but she encouraged me to be in church. And even though I was going to church, I did meet Christ in a crusade organized by the Reverend Dr. Umoh, one of the leading evangelists in Nigeria.
Tell us a little bit about how you are empowering the business communities in Africa.
Okay, thanks. Empowerment is about giving abilities. It's about giving an endowment to make people actualize their dreams. Mm-hmm. And in Africa, from my experience, having worked as coordinator of the Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International for West Africa for over 10 years, I realized that people are more in darkness than in light. That it was not necessarily the money that made the difference. That if they had the spiritual light, it would enable them to do things better. Mm-hmm. And so part of our responsibility is to ensure that they have the understanding of the necessity to have God. Not in saying prayers mm-hmm. before a meeting, not in praying in the office before you start a meeting or you start work in a day, but having Christ woven into every fabric of whatever you're doing, having him take first place, you know, in every decision, considering how he would feel if, you know, things... You were not consulted as part of the entire setup of the organization. And so that's the first level of empowerment, ensuring that people have the spiritual understanding about the necessity to have God be in their business. Not be there as a figurehead, but be there as an integral part of the runnings, of the operations mm-hmm. of the organization on a daily basis. That's the first level of empowerment. The second level of empowerment is the empowerment for knowledge. I also discovered that people have money and they take off into business mm-hmm. and thinking that they know everything about the business. That I know about car plugs, for example, mm-hmm. or I can have a spanner, doesn't make me a mechanic.
Right.
And so if I have, or I know about certain drugs, maybe aspirin or whatever, that doesn't make me a doctor. So the person who wants to run a business must have knowledge of what it takes to run a business. He must have skills to run the business. So it includes things like knowing how to deal with your customers, knowing the market, knowing how to deal with opposition, with competition, knowing how to get people satisfied when they come into your business, knowing how to deal with dissatisfied customers, knowing how to have products which would meet their need, also knowing how to get the business to know the customers and give them the products or the services which meet the needs of the customers. So these are things that we do not know. Most businesses want to please everybody. Mm-hmm. And of course, we know it's not just possible for us to please, for any business to please all its customers. So once you're able to give them that knowledge and the skill, then that helps them to improve on their business growth and success chances. And then the third level is a level of financing. Because of the nature of our environment where poverty is prevalent, mm-hmm. people need something to jumpstart them, to kickstart them into businesses so that they can do well with whatever they're doing. Yeah. Those are the levels of empowerment that we're involved in.
And so I'm reminded of the scripture where, you know, God is giving that parable. Jesus is giving the parable to count up the cost.
Oh, yes.
And to make sure that you know what it takes in order to do business and to function in a way that's going to be successful.
That's right.
Now, as a Christian leader and businessman, what has been the impact of your ministry in your community?
Well, there has been an impact. Number one, creating the awareness that we need Christ in our businesses.
Yes.
It's not something that has been common.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow, where I come from, there seems to be a dichotomy between the person and his business, church and the individual.
Mm-hmm.
And so he has one dress he wears to church on Sunday, and then on Monday he has another dress he wears to work. And so the Sunday dress does not appear in the workplace,
merging,
so to speak.
Merging the sacred.
Yes, and the sacred. And so the impact we've had is to create this awareness to many businesses that you need to have this measure
mm-hmm.
for you to have a lasting success. You can have some success, but you see, success that does not last is not success. Success that fritters away after a little while is not success. But once you have this measure properly done, then your success keeps lasts. Then the area of the Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International, like I said, I worked in West Africa for 10 years
mm-hmm.
across the nations, Senegal, Niger, the Gambia, Ivory Coast, or Cote d'Ivoire, as they call it, and so on. All these nations. I worked in sub-Central African countries, Cameroon. And so we have tried to create this awareness. And then for the Christian community, especially the pastors, for the past 16 years, we have run this training which helps pastors to appreciate the need for having a proper understanding of leadership and administration in the church. Truly, they have gifts and they have talents.
Mm-hmm.
But again, you need to have understanding of how to deal to make these gifts profitable to people. Mm-hmm. If your interpersonal relationships are not right, your gifts don't mean anything to anybody. And so we have had this meeting going on for the past 16 years, which has helped thousands of pastors to make a difference as far as their business, I mean, as far as their church
Amen.
Is concerned. Yeah.
Amen. And of course, even in a ministry operation, you do need to have a level of understanding about business.
Of course,
because there
yes.
is a business portion.
It's God's business.
Yes, it's God's business, and we want to make sure that we're good stewards over what God has given us.
That's right.
What would you say today? I know that, you know, worldwide, there's lots of economic uncertainty,
yeah.
And especially with the business community. What would you say to our audience today to bring hope and to bring encouragement in that area of ministry?
One, I would say that this season is one of the best seasons because it shows to us the love of Jesus Christ to the world. And so in this season, there is hope. I read in the scriptures, there is a word that the Lord gave to me in Genesis 47:27, where the Bible says that the children of Israel settled in the land of Goshen, and there they multiplied. For us as Christians, it doesn't matter the level of turmoil. We are asked to settle where we are and make a difference. God expects us to multiply. God expects us to be fruitful in this wherever He has kept us. And with Him, it becomes easy for us to actualize this goal.
Thank you so much for sharing with us on today. And those three principles, I just want to put them back into our viewers' hearing again, that we must have the spiritual component of our business, that God must be first, and not only first, but that He needs to be in every part of our business.
That's right.
And that we need to have the skill set,
that's right,
to go along with our spiritual operation, mm, and trusting in God for our business.
That's right.
And that we also need to have an understanding of the financial side,
that's right,
and being able to count up the cost before we venture into business. As we wrap up today, Abraham, can you lead our viewers in a prayer of salvation today and a prayer of wisdom?
Okay. The Bible says that David led his people with integrity and skill. So if you're out there listening to us and you do not have integrity, you do not have Christ in you, you have not had a personal relationship with Him, this is an opportunity. It doesn't matter where you are. It's an opportunity for you to get to know Him. If you just say these words with me, dear Lord Jesus,
I come to you today,
knowing that you are the light,
knowing that you are the
and
light,
that you can lighten up my life,
and that you can lighten up my life,
and you can take care of the darkness that is in me.
You can take the darkness that is in me.
You can turn it into something beautiful.
You can turn it into something beautiful.
I ask today that you come into my life. If you said these words, I will say a short prayer with you. Father, these ones have called you, but asked you to come into their lives. Remember you said when you are at the door knocking, if you open the door, then you will come in. And so the door has been opened. I'm asking, Lord, that you will come in into their lives. You will take over. And then you will do that only which you alone can do. Bring a turnaround in their lives. I pray that you will grant unto them wisdom, the practical insight into life, into whatever they are doing in their businesses, in their marriages, in their ministries, that you get them that practical insight. I ask, Lord, that you endue them with that wisdom, that as they wake up each day, they will know what to do and how to do about it, to go about doing it. I ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And we thank you so much, Mr. Umoh, for joining us on today. And we thank you, our viewers, for joining us here at AGTV. If you have received Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, we would love to hear from you. Until next time, may the grace and fellowship of our Lord be with you all from faith to faith and glory to glory.